the extraordinary month of mission. The Church of Christ on mission in the world, baptized and sent. A brief presentation on the life of Saint Vincent Pallotti, a forerunner in mission during his time. Saint Vincent Pallotti was born on April 21, 1795 in Rome. Baptized in the Basilica of San Lorenzo, named as Vincent Aloysius Francis, and came from a very devout family. Vincent Pallotti joined the seminary at the age of 12. He was ordained priest on May 16, 1818 in the Basilica of St. John the Lateran. He kept alive the Christian faith of the people of Rome by helping them not fall prey to the secret societies. In 1818, Vincent Pallotti obtained doctorate in philosophy and theology and was a professor in the University of Sapienza. Having great faith in the Lord, he dealt with courage the problem of cholera. He was a chaplain to the captives. Pallotti was a powerful preacher, a wonderful spiritual director, and an inspiring confessor. He was very close to the children and the youth. Considering their plight, he started night school for the orphan boys and girls. Pallotti reached out to the sick with the Eucharistic Lord and also made sure that he listened to their confessions. He was called a patron of the dying. He was endowed with supernatural experiences such as the gift of bilocation, levitation, ecstasy, and exorcism. His motto was, "The love of Christ urges us all." Through which he envisioned to make everyone a Catholic, to make every Catholic a good Catholic, to make every good Catholic an apostle. Therefore, all are called to be apostles. The source of our apostolate comes from Jesus Christ himself. Therefore, he called Jesus Christ as the apostle of the Eternal Father. In order to reach out with the Word of God and promote missionary activities and Catholic apostolate, that is, to reawaken faith and enkindle charity and unite every Catholic in communion with Christ. Vincent Pallotti founded the Union of the Catholic Apostolate on January 9, 1835. The purpose was to involve the lay faithful in active ministry. However, because of the presence of the secret societies and other rebellion groups which highly influenced the lay faithful of the Union, Vincent founded the Society of Catholic Apostolate and that of the Sisters to animate the lay faithful. The UAC was internationally recognized only in the year 2003. Paloti breathed his last on 22nd January 1850, was beatified on 22nd January 1950 by Pope Pius XII and canonized on 20th January 1963 by Pope John XXIII. On 6th April 1963, St. Vincent Paloti was named as the patron of the Pontifical Missionary Union of the Clergy by the then Pope, Pope John XXIII. The Palatines in India had their humble beginning on June 27, 1950. The Ripe region was entrusted to the South German province of the Society of the Catholic Apostolate. It was raised to the status of the Apostolic Prefecture on January 16, 1964, with German Palatine Fathers John Wedner as prefect. It became a suffrage to Bhopal Archdiocese in Madhya Pradesh on July 28, 1964. Raising it to a diocese on July 5th, 1973, Father John Wedner, SSC, was nominated its Apostolic Administrator on February 8th, 1974. With the sudden death of Father Wedner on August 17th, 1974, another German Palatine Father, Francis Werner Honold, was appointed his successor. He resigned on December 27, 1984. After 50 years of Palatine presence in India, the Prabhu Prakash province was divided into three entities, namely Prabhu Prakash Province, Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary Province, and Krista Jyoti Province. Prabhu Prakash Province has its headquarters in Nagpur, while the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary Province and the Krista Jyoti Province have their headquarters in Bangalore and Raipur correspondingly. With 196 Palatine priests, Ibiriam province stands tall in human resources in the Palatine fraternity. The administration of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary province is entrusted into the safe hands of Father Pedro Camilo Simoes, the provincial rector, and his counselor, Father Arugisami Santiago, Father Victor Prasanna Matis, Father Sahaya Anand Clement, and Father Choji Reddy Dunati. Father Jacob Nambudukam, Director General of the Society of the Catholic Apostolate, along with the Provincial Rector, Father Camillo Sumayas, and his team. Today, the ABVM province covers 6 states in India and attends to the sufferings of the poor and gives them the tools to transform their own lives. The Union of the Catholic Apostolate, the spiritual principles of the founder, St. Vincent Paolotti, continues to guide the Palatines in their work among the disadvantaged people in different states of India. Such as Andhra Pradesh, Goa, Tamil, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and Telangana. Apart from being active in various ministries, the Palatines in India are also active in the social apostolate, like for instance, school-going children. This implies the following: educational assistance, supportive education program by way of supervised study, free tuitions and special coaching, career guidance. The social awareness programs such as HIV/AIDS, alcoholism and drug addiction, legal and consumer rights. Women empowerment. This implies leadership training, healthcare programs, nutrition, skill development programs like tailoring, food processing, handcrafts, etc. The Palatine Fathers presently are also effectively involved in ministries such as the parish ministry, both in India and foreign missions, education ministry, institution for lay empowerment, and ashrams, catering to the spiritual life of the Catholics, organized and animated by the fathers in an Indian style. Chennai Pacifica Coaching Academy. Para Goa Institute for Reach Out Programs. The residential school at Warangal, Andhra Pradesh, which is named as Millennium High School, both for boys and girls. St. Vincent Paolotti Matriculation School at Salem. Paolotti Home Retreat Center and Minor Seminary at Goa. Pillar Institute for Lay Animation and the like. Thus, treading the path of St. Vincent Paolotti, the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary province covers 6 states in India as well as those missions outside India, catering to the sufferings of the poor and ministering according to the need of the hour through effective ministry. Moreover, with the recognition of the union of the Catholic Apostolate internationally has made reaching out with the spiritual principles of our founder, Saint Vincent Pallotti, easy. The ministry of the lay faithful through the union has indeed made the vision of Saint Vincent Pallotti reach out to the periphery with effective ministry all over the world.